And Benji, tell our viewers what happened. You were in the car. There were a few of you in the car. And can just take us back to the moment that the bomb hit.
Yeah, there were five of us in the car, and we were filming in some of these abandoned villages just outside Kyiv, totally bombed to the ground by Russian shelling. They were quiet when we were there. We thought Russian troops were 20 to 30 miles away. But we'd finished filming, we'd done our work, and we were making our way back slowly towards Kyiv, towards the city. And we slowed down at an abandoned checkpoint, and out of nowhere, the first bomb came flying out of the sky, and you hear that whistle first. And it landed about 30 feet in front of us. We quickly tried to reverse the car, but a few seconds later, the second bomb landed right next to the car. And after that one, I blacked out at first, and I believe I had got shrapnel in my eye and shrapnel in my neck. But amazingly, at that point, when I was almost out and I was almost gone, in front of me, to me came my daughter Honor, as well as Iris and Hera, and I saw them all. And they said to me, they said, "Daddy, you've got to get out of the car. Got to get out of the car." And amazingly, I came back, I opened my eyes, I grabbed to the door, I took two steps, and then the third bomb hit the car itself. That one threw me away, and I woke up on fire with my right leg missing, my left foot missing, and a lot of other injuries as well. But amazingly, that moment was what saved me. That ability, my daughters came to me and told me to get out of the car. And that kept me alive that day. And I was there for 40 minutes. No one knew where we were. There was no cell phone reception. There was no way of contacting anyone. And so I sat there and I was thinking, how do I get home? How am I going to see my wife again? How am I going to see my children again? And I thought, well, I'm going to have to crawl if I have to. And amazingly, a Ukrainian Special Forces patrol had come driving past. They didn't see me at first. And so I crawled, I pulled myself up, very badly injured. I pulled myself up to the road. And about 10 minutes later, they came back again. But those 40 minutes there, they were some of the, you know, the hardest of my life. But all I could think about was, how do I go home? How am I seeing my family again?
Just unbelievable, just incredible, the strength and bravery to keep yourself alive for those 40 minutes and to get out of the car. Alicia, you know, you've heard this, you've heard Ben talk to you about this so many times, but every time you hear him say that your daughters came to him and told him to get out of the car. I mean, you just get goosebumps.
Yeah.
Do you think that was a guardian angel? What do you think that looking out for him?
I've always believed that there's something bigger than us out there. I have no idea. All I know is that I guess whatever it is that made him get out that car, Honor, the girls, us. I mean, so incredibly proud of them, of him, of all of us for just
such
getting through it.
Such a special family.
Oh, thank you.
and Benji, you know, you've looked back at some of the footage from that time, and the very first thing you were doing, I mean, you were nearly dead, you know, literally, and you were just wanting to call Alicia. You just kept asking for a phone.
Well, that's right. Well, at the time, we couldn't get out of Kyiv. The Russians had almost surrounded it, and there was no way to get out. And I was in a small Ukrainian hospital, military hospital. And Fox News, they sent in this incredible team of former military, former intelligence to come and find me. And there was this incredible evacuation, which I talk about in the book, which is that they didn't know where I was. They couldn't get me out. And in the end, we found out that the Polish prime minister was on the first covert visit to meet Zelensky. And if we could break through the lines and get through these checkpoints, which were, you know, guns out at everyone, checking my wounds at everyone with no pain meds, then we could evacuate with the Polish prime minister.
Wow.
But all I remember thinking was, if I just need my phone, I just have to call home. I just need to let Alicia know that I'm okay. And then there were these, we got onto the train with the Polish prime minister, just with minutes to spare in the middle of the night, breaking these curfews, and then began 10 hours of really difficult, you know, no pain meds, trying to get to the Polish border. And the US military had said, if I could get to the Polish border, they would help me. And there was a Black Hawk waiting at the other end. But what got me through those difficult moments, what got me through the incredible pain, was just thinking about my family, thinking about what's important in life. And the same is true for my entire recovery. Every single day when I couldn't walk, when I was learning to walk, when I got prosthetics, it was, how far can I walk today? I'm going to walk further than I walked yesterday, and I'm going home again. It's amazing how much power that can give you.
Yeah.